King David said, and I agree totally, it is good to be in the house of the Lord. Good morning. So glad to see you all today. Good to be back with you after a couple of weeks. Thank you for Robert for filling in and wonderful messages. But it is good to be in the house of the Lord on this first Sunday of Advent, the day of hope. And we certainly have a lot of hope. So we're going to hear about that today and throughout the next several weeks, actually. I want to welcome those that are visiting with us online, and if you're visiting with us here today in person for the first time, we have a special gift for you out in the narthex at our welcome station. Hope you'll stop and pick that up today before you leave. And for all of you, check us out online. See what we're all about, what we're into, how you can fit in, how you can help and serve and worship here at Norcross First. I want to thank everybody that came out and decorated last Sunday. The sanctuary looks beautiful. Thank you for all who did that, for Robin overseeing that. It takes a lot of people to make it look this good, so thank you for that. We'll be here all season for us. A couple of announcements to let you know of our Jet Set. Our older adult group is meeting this Wednesday. It's their Christmas gathering at December 1st at 11 a.m. be in our fellowship hall. And they invite everybody to come, regardless of your age. So if you're able to come this Wednesday at 11, bring a covered dish to share. They're going to have some music, Sounds of Christmas, presented by Timothy Jones on the piano. He has played here before, and that'll be a good thing. So that's this Wednesday. Our family Christmas party is next Sunday, our church family Christmas, next Sunday, December 5th, 5 p.m. in our Family Life Center. Get to use that again. That'll be good. Everyone's invited to come share this meal with each other. There'll be some singing, a little Christmas message. There's all kinds of little booths going to be set up. Robert Vieira, if you'll see him, Robert, wave your hand over there so they know who. He's the guy that's been preaching the last 2 weeks. So that's who that is. So, but he's our family ministries director. And so check with him if you have any questions. That's next Sunday. It's going to be covered food is there for us, right? All provided, so you just need to come, and so you'll hear more about that this week, though, so that's next Sunday. And our Advent invite cards, Andy, our communication person, put together these little cards. They're like your own name tag size. Name tag size. All right, good. A lot of you wore them, but they're really cool. They have a little code on it. Hand it out. When you go out to eat, leave it with your tip, and people can pick it up. It has everything that's happening in our life of our church for this Advent season. It's really neat. So pick some up when you leave today. Give them to family, friends, and especially near where you are and near to this church. Invite folks to welcome in Christmas this year. It'll be great to be back together for Christmas. Lots going on in the life of the church, so check us out on our website for more information about that. One of the best things I think we do in the life of the church, traditions at Christmas, is the lighting of our Advent candles and our Advent readings. We're kicking off today with the candle of hope. Phil and Catherine Baldwin are going to come and do that for us and get this season started right for us.
From Jeremiah 33:14 through 16, the days are coming, declares the Lord, when I will fulfill the good promise I made to the people of Israel and Judah. In those days and at that time, I will make a righteous branch sprout from David's line. He will do what is just and right in the land. In those days, Judah will be saved, and Jerusalem will live in safety. This is the name by which it will be called, the Lord, our righteous Savior. We have endured these past few years and know that there is more to face before us. We don't know if we have the strength to withstand what might be around the next corner, and we wonder who will stand with us, who will have our back. Who will occupy our corner? Who is with us? That is what we begin to wonder these days. Who will light our way and chart our course? Who is on our side? Who will welcome us home again? Home? The prophet Jeremiah speaks of a branch that will be raised. Jesus spoke of a son of man that will descend. Both point to a hope that calls us home, our true home, where we are welcomed and loved and included, where there is justice and equality and hope. It's time, this Advent season, time to go home.
We light this first Advent candle as a sign of our hope, our strong hope that there is a way to go home, to the home in Christ. And it starts with us, and it starts here, and it starts now. It's time to go home. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, as we begin this Advent season, remind us of the great hope we have in you, in your Son, and in your Spirit. Help us to focus our hearts, souls, and minds on the hope offered to us through the Christ of Christmas during this season and always. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Lord, what a flame.
Thank you, choir. Let's stand up and greet each other. Let them know that you're glad they're here in the house of the Lord. If you're worshiping with us online, so glad you're with us this morning.
As you return to your pew, let's join together our voices as we sing our opening hymn, Come Thou Long Expected Jesus.
Man, please be seated. We're in this season of Christmas. This is the Advent season, and we're going to be singing and talking about a lot of different things this year of hope and peace and joy and love. One of the things you're going to notice is we're going to have special music every week, and I am blessed to have my sister come and to sing with me today, and so we will be hoping to get this into that hopeful spirit of where we are this time of year, so hope you enjoy. It's called All Is Well.
Sing all. We reaffirm our faith using the historic Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
All right, guys, this is one of my favorite times of the year. Eddie often mentions about how much I love Christmas because it's true. We've been playing Christmas songs a lot. Who here is playing Christmas songs at their house? Amen. Tis the season. So this song is called Hark the Herald Angels Sing, Key of E. Righteousness, light and life to all he brings, risen with healing in his wings. Mild he lay his glory by, born that man may no more die. Born to raise the sons of earth, born to give from second birth. Hark the herald angels sing, glory to God, the newborn King.
Amen. Amen. Please be seated. We come to this time of prayer, concerns, and joys as well. And God wants to hear from us, wants to hear our prayers as we lift them to them. I want to take a moment, just personal thank you for all of your prayers. Keep them coming. The doctor said 3 to 6 weeks, which meant 1 week to me. But it's a slow process, so I appreciate it. And Sarah and I thank you for your prayers. I know that you have many things on your heart. This time of year, let's remember our military especially, who are away from family and friends as they're serving around this world. Remember those who have lost loved ones, who are facing these first holidays without that loved one. But God also wants to hear your joys. So let's spend a few moments in your quiet time with God. Lift your concerns, give them your joys and praises, and then I'll lead us as we pray together. Let us pray. Father, how grateful we are, and how great is your faithfulness to us. Lord, we're in this wonderful season. For many, it is the most wonderful time of the year. For others, it's difficult. But regardless of what's going on in our lives, regardless of where we are in our growth and our journey with you, we come to you with great hope, knowing that when our hope rests in you, we are never disappointed. For we have all tried and put our hope in things, in people, in stuff. But you're the only constant, the only 100% consistent hope giver. And with that, Lord, we are filled with that great hope, and we can offer that to others. So we do so today, lighting a candle of hope, reminding us that it comes from you. It's a gift, and one that we can give to others. During this season of hope, during this time of worship, we have heavy hearts and burdens. Remind us how Jesus said he will take those for us, for his burden is light. May his light shine through us. Hear our prayers, search our hearts, know us, and fill us back up today. Fill us with this great hope and peace and joy and love that we're going to hear about over the next month. Fill us to overflowing so we can share these great gifts with others. God, ask your blessings on our time of worship here and in the chapel with our Hispanic brothers and sisters. Pray your blessings on Carlos as he delivers that message. And I pray that something in this worship service would inspire us, would encourage us, would give us hope. So when we leave from this place today, not only will we see you in all things, but all things will see you in us. Let our light shine. Help us be hope bearers to the world. Guide us by your Spirit. Forgive us of our sins. Show us the way. And we'll give you all the honor and glory. If we lift this prayer up and all of our prayers in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, our Savior, the Christ of Christmas. And we pray the prayer that he taught his disciples, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Amen. Thank you, choir. As we come to this time for asking God to bless our tithes and our offerings, there's different ways that you can give, and we're grateful for the ways you've done so. Cheerful givers, God loves that, and we're grateful for your gifts. You can do so here in person on Sunday mornings. We do have our envelopes in the back and our collection boxes as you leave the service. You can mail in a check to the church. You can do online contributions through your own bank. You also can do it through our website, many different ways. And you also can text Norcross First to 73256. Just different ways to be able to give back to what God has done for us. Let's ask his blessings on it. God, thank you for this opportunity we have to give from our hearts, to trust you in it. Lord, we ask that you would bless both the gift and the givers to the works of your kingdom here on earth so your gospel would spread, your kingdom would grow, and more people would know about Christ. For it's in his name we pray. Amen.
Choirs of angels. Oh, sing, choirs of angels. Sing in exaltation. Oh, sing, all ye citizens of heaven above. Let's do that again.
Thank you, Derek. Appreciate it. I wish he liked Christmas music, though. That's the only thing. Our scripture reading today is from Isaiah chapter 40. We're looking at the first five verses of that. I ask you to stand as you are able for the reading of the scripture today. Isaiah 40, 1 through 5. Hear these words. Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry to her that she has served her term, that her penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Amen. Please be seated. Let us pray. Lord God, open our ears, our hearts, our eyes, our very being, so we can hear and see and experience the message you have for us today. Fill us with your spirit in such a way that we are reminded of the great hope that we have in you. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So we're in the Advent season. Advent means adventure. We're on an adventure together. And I think too many times we don't think of it that way. We look at Advent, we look at Christmas with all the lights, with all the happy and the sounds and the smells and the chaos and the hecticness of it and the family and friends and the parties and the things we have to do. Do we look at it as a time to prepare? Are we really preparing for Christmas Day in the sense of our walk, our journey, our adventure with Jesus? I hope that's what we have this year. Last year, Christmas was different. It was kind of taken from us. And so we're back this year. And so kind of a theme that I stumbled on for this Advent season is coming home. You heard the Baldwins read for our Advent reading this morning, that home word, that coming home. And what does that mean? What does that mean for us? It has different meanings for different people, what it means to go home again. So it's kind of a background theme to how we're going to look at what Advent, this time to prepare, what it's really about. What does it mean to you? Is God calling you to come back to him? You know, hope is an interesting word. We have hope in a lot of things, don't we? I mean, we put a lot of hope in a lot of things. When you get married and you have a family and you have a job, you do all these things, you hope a lot. When your kids start to grow up, you hope. You have hopes for your kids, for your grandkids. You have hope when things aren't going your way. You hope they were better. You hope something changes. You hope things get a little different. I know that hope is something that we can give. So if you're looking for that perfect gift this year, you know, everyone says, oh, this person's the hardest person to give something for. It's hard to wrap hope, but try giving it. In fact, try giving all these gifts of hope and peace and joy and love. We're going to light all the candles this year for that. Hope, peace, joy, and love. We talk about it every year at Christmas, and we wonder, why can't we get more of it? Well, try giving more of it. So we're going to try and give a little bit more hope. So if you're looking for that gift, it's right there. Perfect. But how do you do it? How do you give the hope that you have inside of you to other people? How do you look at a situation, look at a person and say, wow, they just seem down. How can I help? Well, hope is that perfect gift. And we're going to look at this adventurous hope this year, an abiding peace. We're going to look at an authentic joy and an amazing love. Those are all the candles that we light, all the words each week. This week is on hope. We all have hope. What I heard the doctor say 3 to 6 weeks, I could have sworn he said 1 week. And I had great hope. My doctor let me down. First, he accosted me and cut me. They put stuff in my arms and made me go to sleep. And I wake up with a gash in my back. So I have this hope. I hoped I'd be better. I hoped Robert's going to preach 1 week for me, and I'd be dancing back up here soon. And back to my mind, 3 to 6 weeks, 3 to 6 weeks, 3 to 6 weeks. So 2 weeks went by. You know, two is less than three. So my hope is I'm going to stand back there and greet each one of you as you came and hug you like we always do. And after about the third pat on my back, I decided to hide behind the pulpit. Stand up to sing. The joy of music, the joy of singing. My sister and I have been singing a long time together. Our brother didn't get that gene, though. He wasn't a great singer. I'm not a great singer. But the joyfulness of that, and my back of my mind, I'm like, I hope I don't forget the words. I hope I don't come in the wrong time. I hope I don't laugh. But at the end of that song, when we just gave a little hug, sat back down, and I started thinking about the hope we have in each other, the hope we have in family and friends. Hope is a powerful thing. If you lose hope, the world is dark. Everything is hard. Everything is difficult. But when you have that spark of hope in you because of Christ, when you have that joyfulness of hope in you that gives you peace, that allows you to love, you see all of these working together. So hope's a great gift, the perfect gift to give someone. Isaiah spoke of the adventures of life and how we can make a path for others, help others' path to be a little easier. But how do we do it? I think it's the way we live our lives. I think it's the way we handle situations when things aren't going our way, when things are tough and hard and difficult. Our hope is that thing that helps us to continue on the adventure, on the journey that we're on. So we don't lose hope in Christ. This is how we share hope every day, how we live it, how we wake up and say, God, what are we doing today? It's how you start your day. How you invite Christ to be with you every step of the way. I was talking to one of you this morning. We were talking about our masks and wearing them and how we wear them, when we should and who should and how and where. And we realized, made a little bit of a joke about it, but that mask in some ways, if we think about it, is almost like Christ. We keep it close by. We pull it out when we need it. We have it close to us. So how are you going to share this hope? How are you going to share this Christ of Christmas in a hungry world where they want to see it, where they want to experience it? They want to look at you and say, how can you be so hopeful with all that's going on in the world? So you live that hope. You show that hope because it is the perfect gift to offer somebody hope, encouragement, to pick them up when they're down. If the Spirit puts a name on your head or in your heart and in your mind, do more than just say, oh, I hadn't thought about them in a while. Or go, I wonder why they came in my mind. Reach out to them. They may be in need of hope. The hope that you can give. The hope that reminds them they're not alone during this season. We all need people like that. We need to be hope bearers. Someone that gives hope, and we need to receive that too. You probably have a family member or a friend that you can think of right now that they just need to hear a little hope. They just need to hear it's going to be okay. They just need to hear from you that you're with them. As the Baldwin's read, who's going to stand with you? Who's got your back? You can offer that to somebody. So it's a perfect gift. You don't have to search anymore. You don't have to order online. You don't have to stand in line. You already got it. Now, I don't know how well your four-year-old would say, you said, I got you hope for Christmas. They may not understand. But sharing hope. And then after you make that way, after you help make that path, after doing what you can to encourage people, to help people, to offer them this hope, that you make smooth places out of rough places for people. After giving this hope of gift, Isaiah says in chapter 5, then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed and all people shall see it together. It's for all people. That's that perfect gift. For that person it's hard to give a gift for, give them some encouragement. Call them up. Don't wait till the 25th. Send them a message. Send them a card. Give them that gift of hope that tells them it's going to be okay. Look how we've come through this far. Look what we've been able to do together. We're back together. And all people shall see this gift, this hope. I know it's hard. I know if you're feeling down and you're having a tough time, having hope is hard sometimes. Doctors and nurses will tell you with patients, if they've given up hope, there's not much they can do. So we can offer that, give that to others. Scripture is full of stories about hope and hopeful people and what the difference it makes in their lives. And probably for me, one of my favorites is out of Romans 5, where it says, suffering happens, right? We all suffer. We all get down. We all hurt. But that suffering, Paul says, leads to something. It helps. And when we think about our suffering, we know that it leads to perseverance. We persevere. We get through it. And we get through it because of each other. We get through it because we know we have a church family, a loving family. We have family and friends and people who care about us that say, let me give you a little hope today. Let me just hold you, pray with you. Let me just send you a little message. Just anything to give you that hope. It helps us to persevere. We suffer. We persevere. And it builds our character. It helps to make us who we are in Christ. It helps to remind us of who we are, whose we are, and how we can give this gift during this season, especially when people just need to have some hope. And we know that character builds our hope. And Paul says that kind of hope doesn't disappoint us. If you're really honest with yourself, have you ever had those Christmases, especially when you were much, much, much younger, a little child, and you didn't get what you asked for? Did you say, well, there's next year? Did you say, I hoped I'd gotten something and didn't get it? And at that age, we don't understand, there's a little bit of disappointment. I remember one year I wanted a bike so bad. Wanted a bike. And we had upstairs, downstairs, and Christmas was over. There was no bike. Went downstairs. My dad made me go down there to take the trash. So I go down to take the trash, and in the basement with a bow on it was a bike. The green machine. That's all I remember it as. I ran the tires off of that thing. It didn't change. I was a little bit older then. It didn't change my understanding of what hope is really about. Hope is about what's inside of us that we can offer to someone else when they're down. Hope is about not just what we get from ourselves for this, but how we can help others to offer them this wonderful, perfect gift, the gift of hope, to tell them it's going to be all right. God's got you. This can be the most wonderful time of the year. And so can January 4th and February 17th. And on and on and on, because this kind of gift just keeps going. So I want to encourage you to not just receive all the great hope of this time of year, not just to remember all the candles and the festivities and the wonder of the season and the hope that you still have in Christ, but that you can give that to someone else. I hope even before you leave here today, you're already thinking of somebody. You already have somebody in your heart. I pray that God would place on your heart that person that needs to hear from you. You, from you, your hope. is that person? Who needs to see and hear and experience the hope that you have during this season? Oh, let the hope flow. Share that gift with others. Let's pray. God, thank you for the hope that we have in Christ. Thank you, God, that the way that we live is a great example of the hope that we have received. And help us, God, to know that during this season, there are some that are hurting. There are people that are on that verge of losing all hope. Christians and non-Christians alike. People all over the world. And we may not be able to help that person on the other side of the world, but we can help that person in our office, in our workplace, in our school. We can offer hope to those that are down, our friends, our family, and our own household, even in our church. So God, help us to be hopeful and help us to be hope bearers, to show your hope and let your light shine. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Let's now stand together as you're able for our closing hymn. I want to walk as a child of the light.
Now, my friends, go in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Know that you do not go alone, but you go in the hope of Christ. Go and share that hope with others. Go in Christ's name. Amen.